Hi friends, welcome to Sunday Mass with Children. We are so glad that you can join us on this adventure to learn more about our faith.
Hi kids, thank you for sharing your amazing artwork with us, week after week on Little Faith Steps. The entries from our local and international friends are colourful and inspiring. We are always encouraged by your sharings and beautiful artwork. Keep them coming.
Are you enjoying our Bible adventure? I'm sure you are. Last week, we learned that Jesus is the Word, present from the beginning of time, and that God speaks to us through the Bible. Today, we'll continue to discover more about God's Word and what He asks of us. Let's begin with a prayer and a song to Jesus.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Heavenly Father, thank you for loving us so much and for speaking to us through the Bible. May we put into action what we learn in the Bible so that others will come to know of your goodness and greatness. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Let us sing to our God who is bigger, stronger, and awesome in power.
Our God is
awesome in power.
Our God is awesome in power.
The audition results come out tomorrow. I hope our band gets to perform at the parish feast day celebration.
Me too, we practiced so hard.
Me too.
John, did you find something?
But seek ye first thy kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you?
Huh?
It's English, but even I can't understand what it means.
I know what it is. Come on, guys, let's go.
Looks like the boys are having lots of fun on this Bible adventure. They discover something new every week. Have you heard of this Bible verse before? Time to bring out your Bible and look for Matthew 6:33. Matthew 6:33 reads, "But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well." I wonder what this verse means. Shall we find out?
The kingdom that Jesus is talking about is the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is a safe place where we are loved, accepted, healed, and we have peace and joy. If we love God, we will always want to do what is right. And that's seeking God's righteousness.
When God made you and I, He made us in His image and likeness. We may fall into sin because we are weak. But when we confess our sins to Jesus and seek His mercy, we are made right again with God.
If we strive to be right before God and seek His peace and joy, then everything in our lives will fall into place. Jesus taught us how to do this through the many parables that He told His disciples and the people. Like the Good Samaritan, the hidden treasure, the lost sheep, and many more. Don't forget to pick up your Bible and read these parables. Let's see what the boys are up to next.
Are you sure it's from the Bible?
Yeah, I'm sure. I've read it in my study Bible. There it is. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33.
"But seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well."
Ah, I get it. That's another translation of the verse.
Wow. Remember how Mr. Dupont, the owner of the Bible, and Madame Tan, the owner of the Rosary, talked about God speaking to them?
God speaks to us through His Word, and His Word is found in the Bible, in a verse.
A very specific verse. But what does it mean?
God is telling us not to worry about our audition. If we just love God and obey His commandments, He'll take care of us and give us everything we need. We should pray.
Now?
Yes, we can pray anytime and anywhere. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Dear Jesus, we thank you for speaking to us and telling us not to worry about our band audition.
We were anxious, but now we feel assured.
Leave all our worries in your hands because we know you love us and you want the best for us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I wonder who wrote that verse on the magnifying glass?
Now that's another mystery for another time.
Stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
In Matthew chapter 6, 33 to 34, Jesus tells us that in everything we do not have to worry if we turn to Him and choose to do the right thing. God's word is eternal. It is the truth that is spoken in the past, in the present, and in the future.
Noah, Abraham, Moses, the kings and prophets in the Old Testament experienced God's love and saving help for His people. God continues to speak to us today by encouraging, assuring, and comforting us through His word in the Bible. God will continue to be there for us until the day we can see Him face to face.
Wow! God's promise to us is forever! I feel so loved. I'm sure you do too. Now give yourself a big hug and say after me, Jesus loves me.
When we experience the love of God, we can't help but share it with others. So as you learn and grow in the Word of God daily, don't forget to share the good news of Jesus with the people around you. Let us now listen to a story of a holy man who did just that.
When he was young, Venerable Futen Xin lived in a farm that raised animals and grew corn. He complained about doing farm chores but obeyed his parents when they told him to feed the pigs and harvest the corn. In school, he also listened to his teachers who taught him the good news. Futen loved studying God's word, and he was very good at it. To stay close to Jesus, he spent 1 hour with the Blessed Sacrament every day. Listening to Jesus helped him to teach God's word well. His preaching began to bring people to Jesus. The number of people who went to Mass at his church grew from 4 to 90. Soon, Futen became a professor, sharing the good news with people everywhere. He taught in the university, on radio, and even on his own television program. Up to 30 million children and adults watched his program every week. Futen generously shared God's love with others by being kind to them. He listened to troubled people he met on the streets and helped them to find Jesus. He even prayed and fasted for them. St. Pope John Paul II said to Venerable Futen Xin, "You have written and spoken well of the Lord Jesus."
Venerable Futen Xin loved Jesus so much that he will find all ways and means to tell others the good news. He's a role model for us to follow. Let us sing this song to remind us to turn to the Word of God daily, to guide us to live in the kingdom of God.
To my feet and a light unto my path.
For this week's activity, go to our Facebook page, Little Faith Steps. Like our page and share your works in the comments section with us. We can't wait to see them.
The Bible is filled with amazing stories of God's unconditional love for us. This week, spend time in front of your prayer space reading these stories in the Bible. And don't forget to share with us your favorite Bible story on Little Faith Steps.
It is now time to set up your altar table and prepare for Holy Mass. Take a moment now to get these items and see you in a while.
Oh, don't forget to take a photo and post it on Facebook or Instagram with the hashtag CatholicMarsAtHome.
Let us now listen to what Auntie Estella has to share with us in 1 Mass Minute.
When God made the universe, the first thing He created was light. Thousands of years later, Jesus told His friends, "I am the light of the world." We need light to see and understand our world. In the same way, Jesus makes it possible for us to see and understand God. This is why the Church uses light to signal that Jesus is here. At Mass, the candles on the altar remind us that Jesus will be with us in the form of bread and wine. The altar boys carry torches when Father reads the Gospel, because we are hearing what Jesus said and did. And every year at the Easter Vigil, the Paschal candle is lit to show that Jesus has died and risen again. His light has conquered the darkness forever. Is light only used at Mass? No, the red sanctuary lamp burns next to the tabernacle to remind us that Jesus is always present.
Thank you, Auntie Estella. Let us now settle down, sit in front of your altar table, take a moment to be silent and prepare for Holy Mass.
Welcome, my brothers and sisters in Christ, to the Holy Mass with children. Thank you for joining us to sing songs of praise and to learn more about the Kingdom of God and His love for us. There's nothing like giving God our hands and our voices to worship Him as our loving Father. Let us now worship the Lord together on the 5th Sunday in Ordinary Time, 7th February 2021. We offer up this Mass for all those who have dedicated their lives to the service of God. Join us in singing the processional hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today the Church celebrates the 5th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and readings reminds us of God's unfailing care for all of us, and that we must always live in hope that God is always giving us the graces and the blessings we need, and also the protection. So, my dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Have mercy.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that, relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. Job began to speak. Is not man's life on earth nothing more than press service? His time no better than hired drudgery, like the slave sighing for the shade, or the workman with no thought but his wages. Months of delusion I have assigned to me, nothing for my own but nights of grief. Lying in bed, I wonder, when will it be day? Risen, I think, how slowly evening comes. Restlessly, I fret till twilight falls. Swifter than a weaver's shuttle, my days have passed and vanished, leaving no hope behind. Remember that my life is but a breath, and that my eyes will never again see joy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I do not boast of preaching the gospel, since it is a duty which has been laid on me. I should be punished if I did not preach it. If I had chosen this work myself, I might have been paid for it. But as I have not, it is a responsibility which has been put into my hands. Do you know what my reward is? It is this, in my preaching, to be able to offer the good news free and not insist on the rights which the gospel gives me. So though I am not a slave of any man, I have made myself the slave of everyone so as to win as many as I could. I made myself all things to all men in order to save some at any cost. And I still do this for the sake of the gospel, to have a share in its blessings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On leaving the synagogue, Jesus went with James and John straight to the house of Simon and Andrew. Now Simon's mother-in-law had gone to bed with fever. They told him about her straight away. He went to her, took her by the hand, and helped her up. And the fever left her, and she began to wait on them. That evening, after sunset, they brought to him all who were sick and those who were possessed by devils. The whole town came crowding round the door, and he cured many who were suffering from diseases of one kind or another. He also cast out many devils, but he would not let them to speak because they knew who he was. In the morning, long before dawn, he got up and left the house and went off to a lonely place and prayed there. Simon and his companions set out in search of him, and when they found him, they said, "Everybody is looking for you." He answered, "Let us go elsewhere to the neighboring country towns so that I can preach there too, because that is why I came." And he went all through Galilee, preaching in their synagogues and casting out devils. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, you know, once upon a time, there was a boy called Aiden. He was a very polite boy, a very happy, helpful boy, and he did his best in whatever task was given to him. But one day, I discovered that he's such a wise and confident boy, in spite of the many challenges that he faced, which was really, really not very easy for him. His parents were all the time fighting, day in, day out. And at times, Aiden had to move from one place to another. In school, he struggled a bit with his schoolwork. Some of his friends were very helpful, others were not. Surely, it was not easy for him. What would you do if you were in his situation? You know, many people in difficulties have cried and cried, and some manage to get help from people who are ready to listen to them and help them cope with their difficulties, with their situations. These people may include relatives who have good listening ears, or teachers who are very helpful, sometimes friends, parents of friends, and also people in church. But others do not go and find help or support, but in their frustration and helplessness, they may end up doing wrong things and get themselves into more trouble. Today in the first reading, we have Job complaining about the difficulties he had to face in his life. So one day lying in bed, he wondered, when will all these difficult days end? It is like every day is like in the night. There's no sunlight. It's so demoralizing. His good friends thought his sufferings was because he did wrong things, so that's why he suffered. But it wasn't true. Job always loved God and his neighbor. He did a lot of good works, using his money to help people, including the poor. You know, oftentimes, our sufferings may be caused by ourselves. I remember when I was young, you know, small, and my grandmother brought me to the market, you know. And I wanted to buy a toy. But my grandmother said, I cannot buy. And then I squat down, refused to move. And my poor old grandmother got no strength to pull me up. And my grandmother said, I do not have the money. I can't buy for you this toy. But I said, no, I want it. So actually I caused suffering, not only to myself, but also to my grandmother. Of course, I regretted later. And I prayed very hard for her, you know. But then there are times when sufferings are caused by other people. It's beyond our control. The sufferings that we cause to ourselves, we can control. We can change our approach, our attitude, you know, to do something positive. But some sufferings are caused by others. Like some people are bullies in school. And sometimes it's not our fault. There are people who are bullies beyond our control. Of course, we can complain about them. Now, Job could not understand why he had to suffer. So he always questioned, why me? Now, one main thing that helped him face his difficulties or suffering is that when he found no answer to his question of suffering, Job continues to hold on to his faith in God. He never gave up his belief that God is always present, and he trusts that God knows everything, and that is enough for him. So he just carries on with his life, doing what he needs to do, just keep doing what is good and right for himself, as well as for others. He may have lost everything, but not his faith in God. Now, St. Paul in the second reading also faced challenges when he tries to bring the good news to people. But he didn't let his difficulties or challenges prevent him from living his life as a disciple of Jesus, meaningfully and fruitfully. He continues to share the good news of Jesus in spite of the obstacles, the difficulties that people gave him. And in the process, he actually helped a lot of people. Now, did Jesus face this question of suffering? Yes or no? Yes? Yes, surely. He not only came across many people who were suffering and asked for his help, and he gave them his help in today's gospel, you notice that? Jesus himself also had his own suffering from people who tried to find trouble with him all the time and eventually crucified him on the cross that you can see up there. You know, whatever sufferings comes his way, Jesus always stayed focused on the love of God and the love of neighbor. And he commit himself to caring for all kinds of people. People around him, rather than complaining and feeling sorry for himself when people give him trouble. Unlike the troublemakers who spend their time finding ways to make Jesus suffer, Jesus spent his time and all his energy caring for people. And that gives people a lot of hope, encouragement, new life. So Jesus was busy himself positively in helping people. In the lives of many people, he personally healed people in need, like Peter's mother-in-law in today's gospel, and many, many others who came to him. He not only bring good news of forgiveness, healing, hope, love. In fact, when people see Jesus, they see the good news. The good news is here. But what made Jesus able to focus himself on doing, you know, what is good, what is right, you know, how to love and so on? Well, today's gospel reminds us that Jesus spent quiet time in prayer. Sometimes when you get discouraged, you know, you must go into the quiet and just remember that you're always in the holy presence of God. And allow God to calm you down and ask God for the strength to face challenges and sufferings in your life. And then after that, you'll feel quite good. You'll be energized to live lives that are positive, meaningful, and so on. So it's important. So today, we're invited to follow Jesus in not allowing the difficulties and suffering in our life to eat us up, but keep our minds on the love of God and focus on helping others to be life-giving by our words and deeds. Instead of being too engrossed with our sufferings and sometimes make a mountain out of a little molehill. Sometimes small things, you know, little problem, we make it very big. So we must pray. Let us ask God to renew our faith in Him, trusting that God knows best, and the day will come when there will be no more tears, no more pain, no more suffering. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We shall now have the profession of faith.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Dear friends, come, let us entrust our prayers to the Father who heals the brokenhearted and binds up our wounds.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Archbishop William, all priests and clergy, that their faithful witness and dedication to the gospel may be an inspiration and a source of continuing renewal within the Church. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For leaders of all nations, that they ensure the religious freedom of all people under their authority, and act to promote racial equality among all citizens. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church, that all the baptized will strive to live and preach the gospel in their daily lives. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the sick and suffering, that in moments of despair they keep faith, trusting that the Lord has not forgotten them, and remembering that the Lord works in his own time. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the people who care for the sick or dying, that their work will bring healing, that they will be encouraged, supported, and appreciated in this work, and that it will be a source of blessing in their life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the intentions we hold silently in our hearts and those who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, you are the source of our hope and strength. As you answer our prayers, keep us always close to you and bring us salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened a way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours for ever and ever.
Amen.
As sons and daughters of God the Father, as children of God, let us always pray with faith, trust, and hope.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I invite you to focus on Jesus, the bread of life, broken for you and me, for all of us, that we may come to a deep, close relationship with him, that we will always turn to the Lord in times of difficulties, as well as in times of joy and happiness, that the Lord is with us and we are not afraid. He cares for us and He loves us. And this spiritual communion that you have with Him right now, you talk to Jesus, thank Him for coming into your life.
We invite all those watching to make an act of spiritual communion with a spirit of gratefulness, thanking God for His infinite love and sacrifice. With humble and contrite hearts, let us express our desire to invite Jesus into our souls. My Jesus, I believe that You are present in the most holy sacrament. I love You above all things, and I desire to receive You into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive You sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace You as if You were already there and unite myself wholly to You. Never permit me to be separated from You. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So thank you for your participation. You have participated very well. I can see many of you were focusing and really praying. And I hope you continue to pray for all your friends and keep safe and continue to give encouragement, especially with Chinese New Year coming. You want to reach out, give encouragement, make the people happy, especially all the elderly people who are very lonely. Yeah? So the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.